folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK. Welcome back to the channel and this week's Behind The Scenes PMT vlog. Today we're in one of my favourite cities in the UK. We are in Leeds, a city renowned for music, the arts, its amazing culture and one hell of a PMT store. I'm going to take you guys and gals on a bit of a shop tour, pick out some cool guitars and bits and bobs which tickle my fancy and I assume will tickle yours as well. So yeah, let's head on inside and see what PMT Leeds has to offer. So as soon as you come through the doors here at PMT Leeds, you're greeted with an array of gorgeous musical equipment, starting here by some fantastic pedals. Got the Strymans up top, some really funky Zvex ones down there. You've got to have some Waller Marshalls when you come in as well. It'd be rude not to. All the Fender pedals, all the straps, all the gorgeous D'Addario accessories. Each more lovely than the last. The world's best Fender strap. Look at that. I mean, I play the Tiger Print one, but that one might outdo it. All the cables and all the Boss pedals themselves are actually set up. So you can just plug a guitar in and try pretty much any Boss pedal out at once. Yeah. The guitar wall is pretty damn impressive here at PMT Leeds. I mean, it's not as big as our Birmingham store one. If you haven't watched the vlog on that yet, give that a watch. And welcome to Europe's biggest guitar wall. But yeah, it's pretty impressive. Starting off here with some gorgeous PRSs. The customs up top, got some beautiful SEs down below. We've got loads of those Bonnie Pink SEs and you've got to check that out. This is my favourite though. That gorgeous blue 24. I really dig the satin CEs as well. Those things are great and all the S2s at the end. It really is quite the sight to behold and I just keep getting haunted by those 59 60th anniversary Les Pauls. Those things are absolutely stunning. I'm not going to play one today, but if you want to hear one, again, check out my vlog from PMT Birmingham where I play a 60th anniversary one, and they're just so gorgeous. This is hands down one of the best, well, the best Les Paul I've ever played. Is it a bird? Is it a plane? No, it's a Duesenberg. Look at these two doozies, haha. Gorgeous things. I adore Duesenbergs. Fantastic guitar manufacturer. They make things that look great, sound great, and play fantastic. You stand out with the crowd when you play a Duesenberg. So this is a Duesenberg Star Player DTV in vintage white, and it's absolutely remarkable. Check that out. So you've got the vintage white on the top, the cream binding, and the black back and sides. I believe this is, it has a center block, it's semi-hollow, but it's maple construction. Maple neck with a bound rosewood fingerboard, 12-inch radius as well. That Art Deco styling is continued on the strap buttons, and even the serial number is a plaque on the back. P90 in the neck, sorry, humbucker on the bridge, three-way kind of Telecaster-style blade switch, one volume, one tone, glorious metal accents around the pickguard. The Duesenberg trem as well is one of the most sturdy, reliable, Bigsby-esque trems on the planet. This is my first time ever playing a Duesenberg, so here we go. Impressive, as you probably saw on my daft face as I was pulling, looking at the camera, making sure it was still recording. This is a very nice, it's very expensive, but it's a very nice guitar. Check it out, I've linked it down in the description box down below, so you can go over to pmtonline.co.uk and please get yourself one because it's kick-ass. They're so cool. If you want to stand out for a bit less, check out Schergold's as well. That thing's badass. Now I love Rickenbacker. They're just a bit too small. These 660s are awesome. The 330s are the slightly bigger ones, but the 660s, as small as they are though, they are great. I mean, let's have a gander at this one. Like the Duesenberg, this is another guitar I've never played before. I've never played a Rickenbacker 660. Smaller body, because I'm a massive guy and this is a tiny guitar for me to hold. Maple body, it's got a through maple neck, as you can see, it's proper through neck.
checkerboard binding. And that kind of glorious, I can't remember, I think it's rosewood, but it's all gloss on the fingerboard. It's like a trait for Rickenbacker. Got the gold pickguard, the gold logo on the headstock, the gold pickguard. Two volumes, two tones, and a kind of like a treble boost bleed switch, I think. If I'm wrong, please comment down below. And the single coils with toaster top pickups. So this is my first Rickenbacker 660 experience. It's very small, but... Sorry, I don't know any Beatles songs besides I only know the Motley Crue version, so I'm sorry for that. So this is that control on the end. And the little I can't remember control. It's kind of like a treble bleed almost, or a high cut. It's something cool. Lots of distortion on, because that's how I play guitar. It's got a lot of tone for a small guitar. What's the most ridiculous thing I can do on this? Volume controls. Okay, the volume controls and tone controls are the wrong way around, but that's totally fine. That bridge is awesome, and check out the there's binding above the fretboard. So that's maple neck, rosewood fretboard, then binding. It's a gorgeous guitar. No wonder it costs so much. The attention to detail is second to none. So many of your favorite new metal songs from 2002 were recorded on one of them. And the cabs are legendary. Hook one of the Messer cabs up with any other amplifier and blow minds. Some legendary orange amps got the AD30, some beautiful new vertical cabs with the neodymium speakers in, so they're not very heavy. Historically, orange cabs are awesome, but they are quite heavy. These new ones aren't a lot of money and they're a bit lighter. Big old Rockverb 50 Mark III combo, amazing tones all combined in a combo. You usually just see that in heads. And the Tremlord down here. Now the Tremlord is awesome because it's Orange's whack at a Fender amplifier. Now let's get back to that guitar wall because I've spotted one of my favorite guitars of all time. This remarkable guitar is the Malcolm Young Signature Gretsch. And it's a sight to behold. The amount of times I've heard people in the Newcastle store or elsewhere saying, I tell you what mate, I hope I get some money off because there's holes in that guitar. How dare you besmirch this guitar. This is one of the most iconic guitars in history. The Gretsch Malcolm Young Signature, it's an iconic guitar. Let's hear it. So this iconic thing is the Gretsch Malcolm Young Signature Guitar. And as a ridiculous AC/DC fan, so much so I've got a lightning bolt on the inside of my arm because I love AC/DC so much, this is an iconic guitar. It's exactly the same as Malcolm's main guitar. Only the bridge pickup, and the bridge pickup is bolted directly to the body, and these pickups have been taken out. It's a semi-hollow guitar anyways, but there's not usually any sound holes, and this is such a unique guitar in that sense. It's got its own unique sound. However, you just want to give it some... It does AC/DC amazing, but obviously it does everything else great as well because it is a Gretsch with the TV Jones. And this crazy tremolo, which isn't actually the original one, it's Malcolm's, the same tremolo Malcolm had on his. It's just a great guitar, and I highly recommend trying one because it's just that tone right there. I don't want to put it down. Check out the gorgeous faded flame on this high performance SG as well. That's a beautiful top. For all the lefties out there and the Sabbath fans, I mean, this is perfect even if you are just a Sabbath fan and you're not left-handed. Iommi was left-handed, and there's a left-handed Epiphone SG Tony Iommi signature with the crosses on the fingerboard here at PMT Leeds. That thing's badass. Right, ladies and gents, this is one of the most ultimate rigs in the history of guitar. An Epiphone Iommi SG with the Gibson Tony Iommi pickups in. It's left-handed just like Tony himself, and a Laney amplifier. The rig Iommi used during Black Sabbath, it's just such an amazing thing. This guitar is iconic. Iommi's left-handed, I'm not left-handed. So, here we go! Gills, that amazing blues musician who plays upside down guitar, but not like Hendrix. The strings are actually like thin to thick. The boss is looking in as well, thinking, what the hell is he doing? So moving along from those awesome guys, you get to Fender Town, but I just want to show you the color of this Streamliner. That's a great thing. And how space age is this stand? Look at that. What a time to be alive. So moving along, first thing I noticed is something which you should check out at PMTVUK, and that is the 70s Deluxe Limited Edition Telecaster. So it's a 70s Deluxe Tele in Butterscotch Blonde, which is quite rare for a Deluxe Tele anyways, but look! It's got a Stratocaster tremolo, which is unique as hell anyways on an already quite unique 70s Deluxe Telecaster guitar. You've got the custom shops, you've got the boxes, you've got the troublemaker, but you've got this. And I don't really know what this is, so it's definitely getting played. I am going to apologise that these vlogs kind of just turn into me playing really expensive guitars and showing you and talking you through them, but you would do the same. I'm let loose in a guitar shop. Of course I'm going to play the daft guitars. So there's lovely blue, it's got the gold foil pickups, there's tortoise shell, there's a switch down here. Oh man, let's hear it. This gorgeous thing is the Fender Parallel Universe 2 Telecaster Magico? Magico? Yes, Magico in faded Daphne blue. And have a look at that. There's two gold foils, which are really unique sounding single coil with a beautiful hollow tone. You've got the mother of pearl binding all the way around the body, and little mother of pearl like pickup rings almost. The half Telecaster bridge. The whole thing's hollow. The flame on the neck as well. All the way to the headstock with the pearl tuners, pearl inlays, block inlays, and a mother of pearl binding. I can't stress how beautiful this guitar is and how scared I am of dropping it because it's very light. Even acoustically, it's very loud. Sorry, I'm in a room right now where it says no demoing in the booth. And everyone thinks it's very funny to take pictures of. Look, there's Dagan demoing in the booth. Anyways, the guitar. I feel like I'm putting a show on for people now, but of the gold foils. They're kind of like an underwound P90 almost. Bridge as well. This thing is gorgeous, and I highly recommend if you're in the Leeds area, coming in and checking out the Fender Parallel Universe 2 Telecaster Magico. The amp I use in 90% of my demos is for sale at PMT Leeds, the Blackstar HT Stage 100 watt Mark II head, and a nice little 2x12. Some silver lines, there's a gent over there actually trying a silver line, it sounds fantastic. As you can see, all the Fenders, got big Noel up there, a bit of Eric Clapton, because why not? Moving along to the more metal guitars. Now these are, this is where it gets really cool. Check out some of these guitars. Schecter C4 in Silver Mountain finish. So that's a very unique finish for a very unique guitar. It's fan fret, it's got the blade inlays, the fanned pickups. That's an absolute beast of an 8th string. I love a Sustainiac, it's like a built-in Ebow on your guitar, so if you want to hear a Sustainiac, check out my vlog from PMT Manchester where I play one of the Chrome Boys, one of the Ibanez Signature Chrome Boys. It's so cool, but Sustainiacs are awesome. So walking around PMT Leeds, I've just stumbled upon one of the most amazing guitar players I've seen in a very long time. This is me, lad. How old are you, dude?
11 and a half.
11 and a half. And boy, can he play guitar. I wish I could play guitar as good as this when I was a kid. Check this out. I wish I could play Metallica when I was that age as good as we got. You're also a fan of dive bombs as well, aren't you?
Yes.
Give us a dive bomb. That's awesome, dude. Thank you so much for your time, man. Rock on. I just keep finding more and more cool things. Look at that. This is one of the Schecter Apocalypse T-style guitars. So it's obviously like a Telecaster and it looks like it's been through the mill. It looks like it's been through the apocalypse. Natural raw tone finish. You can see the whines of the pickups. The pickguard is lovely and rusted. Is it the same on the back? Of course it is. Look at that amazing grin. You got lock and tuners up top. If my camera focuses. That's a very cool guitar, very unique, kind of what Schecter do best. So this Schecter Apocalypse absolutely screams as if it is the apocalypse. You've got that gorgeous kind of face. It looks like it's been buried underground, like next to an old tank from the war, and then pulled out for the 21st century. You've got the Schecter own brand pickups made in the USA, which are coil tappable. Again, very military kind of looking control knobs. You've got that access heel on the back to get to the 22nd fret, no problem at all. The inlays on the side are all luminescent as well. It just absolutely rips. Is like Schecter custom shop spec for not custom shop price. Check it out. Now let's check out the amazing acoustic room at PMT Leeds. Greeted by a couple of silent guitars, some of the most badass silent guitars on the planet, the Yamaha ones. It's a pretty place to be, guys. It's a very pretty place to be. What have we got? Tanglewoods, some beautiful ukuleles. These Fullerton ukuleles are awesome. Check out Sam's video of these fantastic little iconic Fender shaped ukuleles, some glorious Faiths down the end there, and the Taylor Wall right at the bottom. They've got another builder's edition with the scoop to get to the higher frets, so you haven't got to scoop too much wood away from the body and you get to the higher frets easier than you ever could before. Some flame maple, some tortoiseshell pickguards on this 714, all beautiful things. Is that a vintage Fender acoustic? It looks it, 1986. Fender acoustic. That's quite a quirky thing for not a lot of money. Some Martins, the Telecoustics, you can't go wrong with the Telecoustics. I just don't know what to play first. Actually, I know exactly what to play first. You guys gotta guess what it is. If someone walked in now, like, what the hell is that guy doing on what the man? Is it left-handed? I'm just clicking. Is that an armrest? Have I been playing a left-handed banjo? It's a left-handed banjo. That's why it didn't sound good. All jokes aside, PMT Leeds have one of the Martin 00017 Black Smoke guitars in, and I love these. They were released a couple of years ago, and it's just a proper rustic Martin. Martin do rustic like nothing else, because they were crafted in an era where rustic was the norm. It's so cool. Spruce top, mahogany back and sides, mahogany neck with a rosewood board. There's an ebony overlay on the headstock, and look at like the patina. It's not even relicking, it's like patina. It's like you're watching American Pickers on those tuning pegs. Such a cool, beautiful sounding guitar. It's got that kind of raspiness, like the mid-range rasp. It's got quite a thin neck. It's got a thinner neck than what I thought originally. Guitar, and it's not all the money in the world. For the feel and the vibe, it's that old school Delta blues kind of thing. I could be getting that totally wrong, but that's the vibe I get. All the products are linked in the description box down below as well, so check out the 00017 at pmtonline.co.uk. Kind of want to buy it. On the way out of the acoustic room, you're graced with some lovely Washburns and some Alvarez's down there. Alvarez is a great company as well. Check out Alvarez of cracking acoustic guitars. Right on the end as well, you've got a Gretsch 12 string. Look at that headstock. That headstock makes me just want to buy it off the bat. It's got the sparkly binding all the way around this gorgeous jumbo guitar. It's got the classic triangle sound hole. And again, the white Falcon headstock. Binding all the way down the neck. This thing's incredible and great for 18 months interest-free finance with a 0% deposit. Lucy, will you buy me it?
Yes.
Excellent. I just noticed that lovely sign up there as well. Someone's just turned the Taylor logo off, so I'm a bit upset about that. The acoustic lounge is awesome. I'm very jealous of PMT Leeds though. There's three twin reverbs, one, two, and there's a blonde one over there as well. Who needs three twin reverbs besides me? Ridiculous. Now let's check out the tech department downstairs. There's some glorious pianos from all of your favorite brands, Roland, Yamaha, and other common piano manufacturers that I don't actually know because I don't play piano. Let's head up these WWF 2006 stairs from like the Hell in a Cell to the lovely tech department. Now it's really cool up here and you get a great view. Let's have a little wander around upstairs. So you're starting off upstairs with all your favorite interfaces. You've got the audio box PreSonus, the SSL stuff, Focusrite, Rolands, moving down to some beautiful Native Instruments gear. You've got the completes, the tractors, the machines, Synthland, Yamahas, all the core gear. Sorry, I don't know how any of that. This is quite cool up here though. This is a great place to just chill out and play some beautiful pianos like these Nords. I love a good stage three. Too quiet for me, let's fiddle with it. Awesome thing. Then ending at this side. That's a great video, watch that video. Also Sam's with the top five chorus pedals for under 100 quid. Moving along to one of the coolest things upstairs at PMT Leeds, and that is all the studio monitors on display. So each one of these is plumbed in essentially, so you can come down to PMT Leeds with your own music, plug in and try out any variation of Adam Audio, KRK, Yamaha speakers, and other brands that I don't know. Focal. Yeah, get some Focals. I use the Yamahas myself, I think they're great, but each to their own, and they're all here ready to test for you, so you can pick the one that suits you best. Sorry, just keep getting distracted by that great view. Let's go and look at some cool drum stuff downstairs. So that is the tech department, the electric guitars, and some tasty acoustics. just like the studio monitors upstairs. There's so many stage monitors and big RCF systems, Yamaha systems for your band, all plumbed in, ready to go. So you can test out essentially your live sound in this lovely PMT Leeds warehouse. Everything's good to go. RCFs, there's lovely mixing desks. Again, I'm not a tech guy. I don't know how any of this works. I know it's loud and I know the RCFs sound fantastic, but we have got experts in store. So rock up to your local PMT store and chat to some of our PA guys or gals to help you out with the perfect PA system for your band. Whether you're a singer-songwriter, you're a metal band, you're a jazz band, there's something here to sort everyone. Now, if you can't tell by the banging, we are now in the drum department of PMT Leeds. Massive cymbal wall behind us from all your favourite brands, Zildjian, Sabian. I know a bit more about drums than I do PA systems. Remo heads, Evan heads, all the kind of heads and skins. This wall's been taken straight from Halfords. All the drum hardware stuff. Drum accessories.
Sorry.
And all the shell kits. British Drum Company, Gretsch, Yamaha, Tamer, Ludwig, as well as all the sticks. Some electric kits down here as well, the Tour Tech ones. The ones you're hearing over there are the amazing Roland and Yamaha electric kits. And ending in the bass section. Now there's some beautiful basses here. These two are just absolutely unbelievable. That's one of the new Charvel basses. Sparkly green with the cream pickups and the chrome hardware. Bravo, with a badass bridge as well. And this is one of the new contemporary Squire active basses. So it's five string, active circuitry. It's got a roasted maple neck, as does the Charvel bass, and it's not a lot of money for everything that it does. And it's in olive, like a satin olive drab green. You've got bass amps as far as the eye can see as well. There's orange bass heads, there's the little OB1s, Ampegs, Ashdowns, Fenders, Blackstars, some beautiful Squire and Fender basses there. That's one of the road-worn Vinteras, classic vibe. A couple of, what's it called? Is it Dave Murray? Not Dave Murray. Dave Ellison. Signature basses up there. One black, one white. Move along to the Ibanezes. That's a gorgeous thing, but not as gorgeous as this. Where's the headstock? These things are the talk of the town at the moment. These are the headless, aptly named Ibanez EHB-1000S PMM-EHB headless bass. That's a smooth-looking bass. And I've heard it plays like a dream. So I think that's about it for this week's Behind the Scenes vlog. It's getting a bit crazy here at PMT Leeds, which is what we like. Over lockdown, there was no music stores open, so the fact that everyone is in a music store losing their minds and having all the fun in the world and getting the bits of gear which their heart desires most is just unbelievable. PMT are also offering 18 months interest-free finance on all of your favorite brands with a 0% deposit. So save up for the bit of gear which your heart desires most, whether it's a new entire studio setup, a new live rig for your band, a new amplifier, a headless bass, or anything in between. 18 months interest-free finance with a 0% deposit. Also, your chance to win the music. We're still offering win the music. Rock up to your local PMT store and ask how you can win £500 worth of prizes from one of your favorite brands. That's a cool little feature as well. And finally, for the next few weeks, we are continuing our late night sessions here at PMT. I'm here late night on a Thursday between 6 p.m. and 9 p.m. We're giving away prizes like a Black Star Fly, a goodie bag from Ibanez, and a goodie bag from Ernie Ball. This is a lot of fun. Look, there's Drew getting some behind the scenes footage. Absolutely awesome. So yeah, this is a bit chaotic, but we like chaotic here at PMT. Rock up to your local PMT store and hopefully I'll see you guys soon in a late night session for you guys to win some Black Star goodies. Have a good one, folks. I'll see you later.